To worship you, to give you the glory this morning, Lord. We thank you, Jesus, for all the churches that woke up this morning, Lord Jesus. We thank you for the Lord Jesus, Regina Leroy Chapman, Lord. We thank you, Lord, for the First Lady Tillery and Pastor Tillery, Bishop Rodney, Lord Jesus. We thank you for, Lord, Pastor Ryan and Pastor Robert, Mother Lemon. Mother Lemon, Lord Jesus, we thank you for our Lord. And Lord, I thank you so much for the enjoyable time I had with my brother-in-law and my sister, Leroy Chapman, and my sister, Regina Chapman. Thank you for our Lord. I pray their heads of protection over their lives. Bless them wherever they go, Lord. Have your anointing on their lives and bless their family as they go to and from. Bless their family as they go to and fro. Salubrium. Salubrium, if you would. Salubrium is a part of the brain. It's the part of the brain that is located at the back part of the brain, the part that you would call the foundation of the brain. The brain can be divided into these basic units: the forebrain, the midbrain, the henbrain. The henbrain includes the upper part of the spinal cord, the brain stem, and a wrinkled ball of tissue that is called the cerebrum. And the cerebrum, if you would, is the foundation of the brain. And I'm going to get more into that part in a minute. But to make it clear and to clarify it, if you would, it's like cerebral. Cerebral, if you all know, to those who look at movies, the X-Men, is a machine that Xavier used to locate all the mutants and all the humans. It's something that he used to locate them and try to communicate with them so he could actually talk to them. Now, the cerebrum, if you would, of the brain have neutrons. And as I did my research, those neutrons are 86 billion neutrons that are in the cerebrum. The neutrons are produced copiously in the nuclear fission and fusion that are a primary contributor to the nuclear synthesis of the chemical element within the stars through the fission and the fusion and the neutron captivated process, if you would. So what is that? Neutrons, 86 billion neutrons. What you have, my friend, is an army of stimuli tissues that is communicating with the brain. It's the part that is the foundation, the base of the brain, that's telling the brain our system is controlling them, is trying to find out what's going on. And when people come to you and tell you, jump, is the part of the brain that puts you on a stop and so you can think. You could argue it's the fallopian tube, the frontal part of the brain. You could argue that it's part of the hypothalamus of a pituitary brain. And these functions do other things. It tells you about your thinking process. It tells you about your stimulations and whatnot. It has all those things, including in your brain. And God gave us this for a reason. He gave us these parts of our mind as the part that do all the thinking. And the neutrons protect the brain from being deceived or manipulated, if you would. Whether it be disease, and chemicals that kills the disease of the brain, because you gotta think. Whether it be something probing to tear out the tissue, so you can't move your arms right, the slimming. It has something to do with your equilibrium, if you would. So we have all these things that God gave to us, so we won't be like a robot. So we won't be like a puppet. We can think for ourselves. We have a basis of think for ourselves, and it's a part that protects our way of thinking, the way of moving, the way of what we want to be in life and all that and whatnot. And a equilibrium is contributed of 50% of neutrons in it. 50% of it. Acts 2, starting at the first verse. Acts chapter 2. I'm going to start at the first verse. And I'm using my glasses today. And when the day of Pentecost was fully come, and they were all with one accord in one place, and suddenly there came a sound of heaven as of rushing mighty wind, and it filled all the house where they were sitting. And there appeared unto them a covenant of tongues like of fire. A covenant of tongues like of fire. And it sat upon each of them. And they were all filled with the Holy Ghost and began to speak with other tongues. And the Spirit, as the Spirit gave them utterance. Acts 2:38. If you would. Then Peter said unto them, repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ for remission of your sins, and ye shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. He said, you shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. So we talked about the brain. We talked about Acts 2:38, that all, when they believed and trusted in God, all was filled with the Holy Ghost. All, not some, all was filled with the Holy Ghost. Every last one of them. Think about that. Every person in the room was filled with the Holy Ghost. I'm going to pause for a second, and I want you to think about that. I want you to think about, I'm going to pause, and I'm going to let you think. Think about everybody sitting in that room. Everybody. They're sitting in that room. And when they're sitting in that room, the Spirit of the Lord came over them. And when the Spirit, don't look at me, don't think about me, think about what I'm saying. I want you to think about what I'm saying today. Don't think about me, don't think about you, just think about what I'm saying. Everybody sitting in that room. They're sitting in that room. And they're sensitive to what's going to happen next. They're sensitive. In other words, they're not fighting. They have people today sometimes fighting. They're fighting the will of God. They're fighting the Spirit. But when the Spirit came in that room, every last one of them was filled. Not some of them, every last one. Every last one was filled with the gift of the Holy Ghost. Now, the people later came to Peter, and they said unto Peter that, okay, all these people are filled with the Holy Ghost. All of them are filled. Peter told him in Acts 2:38, repent, every last one of you, and be baptized in the name of Jesus, because it's the name of Jesus, that name is the one that's going to save you, because Jesus is standing in the gap. My sermon today, my message is, what is this? Let me tell you something. I went on Saturday, and You see, you got to find out who you are. I told you about the brain, how God has already gave you a tool. You don't need no machine. God gave you a tool to do your own thinking. You don't need nobody to think for you. He gave you a tool to think. He gave you a word. And this word comes from scrolls from long ago that people wrote down, they took as if you would write a diary. When Jesus was walking on the earth, they wrote this stuff down. All his apostles, John, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. That's why they call it the Synoptic Gospels. The Synoptic Gospel means it's the same, but it's different. It's the same. It is the same. Because all of them walked with him, but all of them had their own story. You have your own story. Not just, you have your story, what you experienced with the Lord Jesus Christ. That's what you have. The subject today is, what is this? I was in the store today. Not today, I'm sorry. I was in the store yesterday, mall, looking for something to wear for a party I was going to. So when I went inside the store, I picked up something. And what I picked up was this. I picked this up right here. And I looked at the man, the salesman, and I said, what is this? He said, this is a tennis shoe. That's what he told me. You don't understand what I'm saying. He told me that that was a tennis shoe. What is this? He said, this is a tennis shoe. And then it struck me. When he told me it's a tennis shoe, it really, really struck me. I said, well, preacher, why in the world? We all know that's a, no, you don't understand. Then he looked at me, I picked the shoe up, I gave it, he said, this is a tennis shoe. You don't understand me. This is not a running shoe. It's not a jogging shoe. It's not a dress shoe. It's not a boot. It's none of those things. This thing here is not meant for jogging long distance. It's not meant for running in a sprint. It's not meant for that. It's a tennis shoe. This tennis shoe is meant for only playing tennis. You don't understand me. You got many tennis stars. You got Venus Williams. You tell me Federer and Nadal. You got these other people, I can't even pronounce their name. You got Barter and Martins. All these people who can correlate that's a tennis shoe. It's not a running shoe. It's not, you don't hear what I'm saying. What is this? So when people go to you and you see this man of God dressed, what is this? This is a preacher, a Christian, a gospel person who believed and trusted in God, a person who believed in the Lord Jesus Christ, a person who believed that God is standing in the gap for him. There's no compromise about it. There's no pause about it. That's what it is.